Today, I will show you how to use the Decorator design pattern to add new features to an existing code base. Let's go. I've built a simple web application that allows users to upload images. When the form is submitted, the onPostAsync method is invoked, and it uses the FileService class to save the uploaded image. The FileService class is a simple class that contains a method called saveFileAsync. This method received an iForm object, which represents the uploaded file from the user interface. The saveFileAsync method then saves the uploaded file to the /uploads directory. Let's try it out. I will submit an image and click on the upload button. It looks like the upload was successful. Let's check in the uploads folder. You can see the file has been saved correctly. Now, let's say there is a new requirement to rename uploaded files according to a specific pattern, such as file, underscore, the timestamp. While it may be tempting to modify the FileService class, doing so can be risky, as it could introduce bugs or unwanted side effects for existing clients of the service. So what's the solution then? That's where the Decorator pattern comes into the picture. This powerful pattern allows you to enhance or modify the behavior of an object without altering its original code. By using the Decorator pattern, you can introduce the new feature without making changes to the FileService class. This way, we can avoid potential issues while still achieving the desired result. To understand how the Decorator pattern works, let's take a look at the class diagram. The component interface defines the basic operation that can be performed on the object. The concrete component class implements the component interface and provides the core behavior. The Decorator class, which is an abstract class that also implements the component interface, acts as a wrapper around the original object. The concrete Decorator class extends the Decorator class and adds new functionality to the object by either modifying existing methods or implementing new ones. It's worth noting that the version we'll be using in the implementation won't have the abstract Decorator. Now that we've covered the basic of the Decorator pattern, it's time to apply this new knowledge to implement the new requirement. To meet the new requirement, I will introduce a new class called Rename File Service. This class must implement the same iService interface as the file service we want to modify. The Rename File Service class has a reference to an iFile service, which can be initialized in its constructor. The implementation of the saveFileAsync method in this class calls a private method called RenameFile to rename the file. While the details of this method aren't important, it should return an iForm file interface, which is the type expected by the iFile service interface. Once the file is renamed, I can pass it to the saveFileAsync method of the injected iService instance. This way, we can achieve the desired renaming behavior without modifying the original code. I'm going to complete the renaming implementation, and this is the final code. And now we can return to the page model. So far, I've been using the iFileService implementation that only saves files. However, to add the new file renaming feature, I will create a new instance of the recently created rename file service and passing the original file service as a parameter. To test this, I will upload a file. And then check in the uploads folder. As you can see, the file has been correctly renamed. By using the Rename File Service class instead of modifying the existing file service, I was able to achieve the renaming functionality. Let's take things a step further I have a new requirement to resize the uploaded file if it is too big. Once again, I will create a new decorator, and for that, I will add a new class named ResizeFileService. It implements the iFileService and requires a reference an object of type iFileService. In the saveFileAsync method, we need a function to change the size of the file. The resize image is returned as an iForm file object. Once the file is resized, I pass it to the saveFileAsync method of the wrapped file service. I'm going to complete the code for resizing. And this is how the complete implementation looks like. Now let's return to the page model. I'm going to add code to the onPost method, which checks if the file size is larger than 1 MB. If it is the case, I will wrap the current iFileService instance with the ResizeFileService decorator. This will resize the file if it exceeds the size limit. So let's test this. So I will upload a file that the size is larger than 1 MB. The new file can be found in the upload folder. So let's check the size again. As expected, the file size is smaller. As you may have noticed, the file renaming worked as expected too. So decorators are a powerful tools to combine multiple behaviors to achieve more complex tasks. That's it for today's video. If you have any value from this, like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next time.